Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu
Nasta praeshu vabhadreshu
Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttamashloke.
Bhagavati Uttamashloke.
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki.
Bhakti Bhavati Naishtaki.
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 24, entitled Worshipping Govardhan Hill.
今日我哋阅读圣典《博加亚行》第十篇第二十四章第二十一节，题目系崇拜高弗丹山。
Text 19.
咁我哋读嘅第十九节。
Slow down, you're too fast. Ajivyaikataram bhavam Nimana Ajivyaikataram bhavam
Ajivyaikataram bhavam
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Kalavati, Jautalama. No? Di Shipian, Di Arsha Sajan. Shijo Shijia. Ajivaikataram bhavam
Ajivaikataram bhavam
Yastvanyam upajivati
Yastvanyam upajivati
Natasmad vindate shemam
Natasmad vindate shemam
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Jaran Narya Satiyata
Ajivaikantaram Bhavam
Ajivaikantaram Bhavam
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Jaranaya Satiyata
Jaranaya Satiyata
Ajivaikataram Bhavam
Ajivaikataram Bhavam
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Jaranarya Satiyata
Jaranarya Satiyata
Ajivaikataram Bhavam
Ajivaikataram Bhavam
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Natasmad Vindate Shemam
Jaranarya Satiyata
Jaranarya Satiyata
Ajivyaikataram Bhavam
Ajivyaikataram Bhavam
Yastvanyam Upajivati
Yastvanyam tasmanyam upajivati.
Natasmad bindate kshemam.
Natasmad bindate kshemam.
Jara narya sati yata.
Jara narya sati yata.
Ajivyakta taram bhavam.
Ajivyakta taram bhavam. Yasvanyam upajivati.
Natasmad bindate kshemam.
Natasmad bindate kshemam.
Jara narya sati yata.
Jara narya sati yata.
Ajivya,
Ajivya,
sustaining his life,
sustaining his life,
维持他的生命,
ekataram,
ekataram,
one,
一个,
bhavam,
bhavam,
entity,
entity,
实体,
ya,
ya,
who,
who,
谁,
two,
two,
but,
但是,
Anyam,
Anyam,
another,
another,
另一个,
另一个,
Upajivati,
Upajivati,
求作于,
resorts to,
resorts to,
na,
na,
not,
not,
bu,
tasmat,
tasmat,
from that one,
from that one,
从那一个,
vindate,
vindate,
gains,
gains,
获得,
Shemam,
Shemam,
real benefit,
real benefit,
正经的利益,
Jarat,
Jarat,
from a paramour,
from a paramour,
从一个情夫,
Nari,
Nari,
a woman,
a woman,
一个女人,
Asati,
Asati,
who is unchaste,
who is unchaste,
不境界的,
Yata,
Yata,
as,
禁语,
Translation. If one thing is actually sustaining our life, but we take shelter of something else, how can we achieve any real benefit? We would be like an unfaithful woman who can never achieve any actual benefit by consorting with her paramour.
译文如果意思莫在实际维系我们的生活, 可我们却迫必于另一个事物, 那我们怎么能得到真正的利益? 我们就像不忠的女人, 永远得不到她与她情人结交的真正的利益。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The word Srila Prabhupada or Srila Prabhupada is disciple?
Disciple.
Disciple. The word Kshemam means actual prosperity, not merely the accumulation of money. Here, Lord Krishna boldly argues that just as a woman can never achieve actual dignity or enlightenment from an illicit lover, the residents of Vrindavan will never be happy by neglecting the real source of their prosperity and worshipping Indra instead. According to Srila Jiva Goswami, the audacity that child Krishna displayed before his father and other elders should be understood as an exhibition of transcendental anger, aroused when he saw his eternal devotees worshipping an insignificant demigod.
有是帕布帕的门徒赞成的样子，梵文Krishna，真正的利益，解释指真正的成功，而不指金钱的利益。Krishna再次大胆的辩论地说，正如一个女人永远不可能从非法的臣服那里得到真正的庄严和启明，Vrindavan的居民如果获释了给他们的梵文，唱圣的真正的源头，却是崇拜Indra的话，将永远不会快乐。 按照Srila Prabhupada的解释，儿童的Krishna在他父亲和其他长辈面前表现出的大胆，应该被理解为是，他看到他永恒的奉献者去崇拜一个微不足道的半成人时所检视的悄然的愤怒。
Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurumilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpa Tarubhyasya Kripa Sindhubhaye Vaja Patitana Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Lord Krishna is speaking to his father, Nanda Maharaj. Nanda Maharaj, along with the other men of Vrindavan, were beginning to perform an Indra Yajna. And Lord Krishna inquired from his father about what is the purpose of this yajna. Nanda Maharaj at first tried to tell Krishna, oh, you're just a small boy, don't worry about this. When you grow up, then we'll tell you more.
他的父亲一开始就说, Krishna,
but of course, Lord Krishna is not an ordinary small child. And Lord Krishna continued to inquire from his father that it's important for me. I want to know what you're doing. So Nanda Maharaj explained to Krishna that this is our custom in our family, that every year we perform the worship of Indra. Some things are just traditional and other things are done according to scripture.
有一些都是它是因为传统而进行的，有一些是因为经典的说明而做。
this Indra Yagya was more traditional than scriptural.
而且 Indra 的祭祀它的活动其实是因为传统而进行，不是经典。
So Nanda Maharaj explained the importance of the Indra Yagya to Lord Krishna.
于是他 Krishna 的父亲就又要解释给 Krishna 听，Indra这个崇拜的活动它的重要性。
Because Indra is the god of rain, we have to please him.
因为Indra呢，他是掌控这个雨的这个半成人，所以我们要崇拜他。If
we don't worship him properly, then we may not get rain. If there's no rain, then there'll be no grass.
那如果我们不好好的崇拜他呢，他我们可能没有这个雨水啊。那如果没有雨的话，下雨的话，那我们就不可以有一些好的农作品。
If there's no grass, we won't have anything to feed our cows.
没有草，如果没有草的话，那些牛啊，怎么都是可以吃的。
And we are Vaishyas. We depend on the cows for our prosperity.
我们是 Vaishya, 我们是农乡，那我们是要有牛啊，才可以繁荣繁荣。
So this is the purpose of our Indriya.
那这就是Indra-yakya的重要性。
However, Lord Krishna was not satisfied to hear this.
但是呢, Krishna他不满意这个答案。
And Lord Krishna began to explain to his father that we don't need to worship Indra.
那Krishna之后就解释给他的父亲听说我们不需要去崇拜这个Indra。
Lord Krishna is telling his father, I think you've got it all wrong, Baba.
And Krishna is saying, I think you've got it all wrong, Baba.
Baba, father. Yeah, Baba. Yeah. So, Baba, Nanda Baba. You've made it, you're all wrong. Because look, Indra pours water, it rains on the ocean, the rain falls on the ocean. They don't do any yaga, they don't need any water, but they get rain.
这是他说，你爸爸你全都错了。这些雨啊下到这个海洋里面啊，他们不需要，根本就不需要这个他的什么力量。
Yeah, you have to do yagya to get rain. Why is it raining on the ocean?
如果我们要举行这个崇拜的活动，才会有下雨呢。那为什么他下雨是下到去海洋去啊？
No, it's not. We don't have to worship Indra.
我们不需要去崇拜Indra.
The rain comes. Lord Krishna then began to explain the philosophy of karma mimamsa.
那其实 Krishna 就是解释什么是 karma mimamsa.
Yeah, mimamsa. Karma mimamsa. The teaching of this philosophy is that work is the important thing.
这个教徒的重要就是说明工作的重要性。
If you do your work nicely, you'll get good results.
如果你做好你的工作，你就会有一个好的成结果。
This is not really the correct understanding.
也不是一个很好的理解这个教度的理解。
But Krishna was using this argument to explain to his father.
但是Krishna用解的说法去解释给他的父亲。
Krishna was not happy to see his father worship Indra.
因为 Krishna 他不开心看到他的父亲去崇拜 Indra.
Now Indra is a devotee.
Indra 是一个奉献者.
But
但是
not a pure devotee.
不是个纯粹的奉献者.
Sometimes he's influenced by material desires.
有时候他也会给这个末智去影响.
And Indra is not the supreme lord.
而且呢, Indra 他不是一个至尊主.
Indra is what we call one of the demigods.
他是我们说的就是半成人。
Now he's the king of heaven.
他是天堂的国王。
But he's not the supreme lord.
但他不是至尊的。
He's not God.
他不是神。
But he had become very, Indra had become very proud.
但是呢, Indra 他变得非常骄傲。
Because he's the king of heaven, people were all honoring him and respecting him.
因为他是天堂的国王，人家就很尊重他。
Indra resides in heaven, he's surrounded in heaven, there's many beautiful women.
他住在天堂，周围都是有好多的美女去伴他。
And all of these women, they glorify him and worship and serve him.
这些美女啊，荣耀他，服侍他。
So Indra had become affected by all of the opulence of heaven.
那 Indra 他是给天堂的这些财富给影响。
Material opulence is very dangerous.
物质的财富是非常的。
In Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Bhogaishvarya prasaktanam taya parita chaitasam vaya vasayatmika buddhi samado na vidiyati. That in the minds of those who are attached to material opulence and sense gratification, the resolute determination for devotional service does not take place.
在薄伽梵歌 Krishna 说，如果是给这个末智的财富，欲望
Thought it would be a bit difficult.
It's
affected
by opulence.
Material opulence and sense gratification.
还有感官的享乐影响。
Then the and if you're attached to these things.
如果我们依附在这些东西下面。
Then the determination for serving Krishna will not be there.
去服务 Krishna 的坚定的决心就不会发生。
Have to be very careful.
所以我们要小心。
Wherever there's a lot of wealth and opulence,
如果我们有很多的财富、金钱啊。
Because it goes to the head, we become proud.
那我们的头颅就会给这个影响，我们会变得很骄傲。
We think it's mine.
我们可能会想啊，其实都是我的。
For my enjoyment.
是我的，为了我的享乐。
This is a danger.
这就是危险的。
We forget that we are the servant.
我们忘记了我们是仆人。
So Indra, the king of heaven.
那 Indra 天堂的国王
is enjoying a lot of opulence.
他享受好多的这些财富
sense gratification.
感官的享乐
You know, Hong Kong is like heaven for some people.
对某些人来说，香港就像一个天堂一样
You know, if you come from a village in China, or Russia, or somewhere, you know, and then you come to Hong Kong, or you come from a village in India.And then you come to Hong Kong. Oh.
如果你是从可能印度啊、中国一些村庄、小农村的来到香港的话，这个大城市你可能就会觉得哇、哦，好多。
And of course, people in Hong, not everybody in Hong Kong is opulent.
当然不是所有的香港人也是有钱的。
You know, just like we're down here in Tsung Shan Tsui, but if you go up to the peak, when you think, oh, the peak. Yeah, so much opulence, so wealthy.
有钱财富。
So everywhere there's some opulence. Opulence is of course relative. It's a relative thing. Some what we may think is opulent is actually not really opulent compared to heaven.
那当然的，财富这个概念是相对的。我们可能这里觉得是很美好的东西，但是在另外一线来说，可能不个天堂啊更美好。
So Indra is up there in heaven, and he's enjoying the highest, the greatest opulence.
那 Indra 他在天堂，他是享受着最高的这个财富。
And you become affected by these things.
然后他就给影响了。
Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, would often come to the temple and he'd take all the money from the temple.
Prabhupada's 老师林信道师 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, 他会到庙里面去把所有的钱全拿走。
And he'd make some exhibition or some display of Lord Chaitanya's pastimes.
他会展示一些主场。
And the devotees would complain that, oh, Guru Maharaj, you're spending all the money, there'll be no money left.
他的门徒有时候会投诉，就是说，啊，师傅，老师，灵性导师啊，你把所有的钱全都花光了，然后我们没有钱可以用了。
He said, yes, very good. You have to go out and preach. If you have a lot of money, you just keep it in the bank. You'll just live comfortably. You'll be lazy. You'll just eat and sleep. So, we have to be very careful. At Prabhupada also, when we got money, Prabhupada would like it to use it to print books.
所以我们要很小心，如果我们有钱，有时候他们有钱的话，Prabhupada很喜欢用这些金钱去用来去印印印书本，做书。In
Prabhupada's time, we were printing Srimad Bhagavatam.
在 Prabhupada的年代，他们做的就是佛教瓦坛。
It was coming out one volume at a time.
他们是每一篇每一篇的出版。
Prabhupada was encouraging the devotees like this. Use your money, print books. He didn't worry so much about big temples. So Indra had become proud of his opulence, and Lord Krishna wants to teach him a lesson. At the same time, he also wants to teach the people of Vrindavan. He particularly, of course, his own father. Lord Krishna is going to teach his own father an important lesson. Because Lord Krishna doesn't like to see the people of Vrindavan worship demigods. He wants to see the people in Vrindavan simply engage in pure devotional service. And the pure devotees worship Krishna, they don't worship Indra.
但是呢，他们现在是崇拜，他们要崇拜的应该是Krishna，而不是Indra。
So Lord Krishna is describing this philosophy that work is an important thing. It's not worship of Indra, that's not important. What's important is do your duty. And our duty is to take care of the cows. And the cows, they get the grass from Govardhan Hill. We don't need to worship Indra. Lord Krishna is giving an example here. And he said, why take shelter of someone who's not really giving you anything? Any shelter. And he says it's like an unfaithful, unchaste woman. She may have a good husband at home, but she's associating with another man. So she does not get any benefit from being with that other man.
他跟那个男人呢，不会有任何的利益可以得到。
So Lord Krishna is saying like this to his father.
那 Krishna 就是用这个口吻跟他的父亲说。
You're worshipping Indra. He's not giving you anything.
你崇拜的是 Indra， 他不会给你任何东西。
It's all who's actually giving everything. It's coming from the Supreme Lord.
真正给你。
So, we're told here in the purport that Jiva Goswami comments on this. He said, Lord Krishna is angry. He's angry at this Indra. That this Indra has become so proud.
Indra
thinks he should be worshipped. Now in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says that whatever a man may offer to other gods is actually meant for me alone.
在佛家梵歌，Krishna有说过，任何是给其他的拜神人给的崇拜的东西，其实最后是也是给我的。
But it's offered to these other gods without proper understanding.
Improper understanding.
And whatever these other gods may give, it can only be given by my sanction.
但是如果这些半神可以给的任何的东西，他们可以怎样做，也是因为我的许可。
Also, worship of demigods is done by less intelligent people.
崇拜半神人的人，他们是因为智力不够。
And the result of their worship is material things, limited and temporary.
而他们的得到的结果就是短暂的。
So Lord Krishna doesn't want to see the people of Vrindavan worship demigods. Srila Prabhupada told us that it used to be in Vrindavan, only temples of Krishna were there. There was no worship of demigods. And there were no Mayavadis. The Mayavadis, they worship all the gods. Because they think ultimately there's no god, or ultimately there's only the Brahman. But in the past, none of these people were in Vrindavan. Lord Krishna didn't want them there in Vrindavan. And 5,000 years ago, Lord Krishna is personally instructing Nanda Maharaj and the people of Vrindavan.
5,000年前，Krishna甚至去训斥这些他的父亲和其他的居文。
You don't need to worship these demigods.
你不用去崇拜其他的半神人。
Of course, one item, there are items of surrender to Krishna.
他们是要崇拜神父与Krishna的。
Surrender involves six items.
皈依有六个原则。
And one of them is to know that only Krishna can protect us.
其中一个就是知道只有Krishna可以保护他们。
And only Krishna can maintain us.
而只有Krishna可以维持我们。
But Nanda Maharaj is thinking, no, we have to worship Indra.
但是Nanda Maharaj却想了，我们要崇拜Indra。
But Indra is just a tiny servant of Lord Krishna.
但是Indra他只是Krishna其中一个小小的仆人。
We don't need to worship Indra.
我们不用去崇拜。 Indra.
We just need to worship Lord Krishna.
我们只需要去崇拜 Krishna.
And all the devas are pleased when we worship Krishna.
而当我们是崇拜 Krishna的时候, 所有的半神人呢, 他们也会满意。
We may be thinking, oh, maybe the devas, the demigods will get angry if we don't worship them.
那我们可能会想, 这些半神人呢, 他们可能会生气, 如果我们不去崇拜他们。
And actually we see Indra did get angry.
而我们真的看到Indra他变得很生气。
Indra got angry that, oh, they're not going to do my worship.
Indra很生气啊, 他们不崇拜我了。
I'm going to destroy the whole village.
我要毁掉整个的村庄。
Send my clouds there to flood the whole of Vrindavan.
我会叫来这些语文来去要把这个Vrindavan.
But they'll all drown. They'll all be drowned in the flood.
他们会把他们淹死。
Just imagine how proud that Indra had become. And Krishna knew all of this. Krishna knew what was going on. He understood the problem. But he wants to teach Indra a lesson. And he also wants to teach the people of Vrindavan.
还有他想叫 Vrindavan 的句文.
You just need to worship the cows in Govardhan Hill and the Brahman.
他想叫他们，你们只要崇拜这个牛，还有Govardhan山.
So Lord Krishna was angry. He has feelings. He's a person.
Krishna
has feelings. So we should understand how to please Krishna. And of course Krishna is pleased by loving devotion. We see in the Bhagavad Gita how Krishna explains that he can only be known, he can only be approached by bhakti, by devotion. Loving devotion, pleasing, that is pleasing to Krishna. You can make Krishna angry also. Just like sometimes different demons would come and they would speak very nasty words to Krishna. Pundraka told Krishna, "You give me that Sudarshan Chakra, I'm God, not you." Krishna was not pleased with these kind of words, the harsh words of these demons. Krishna comes to give pleasure to his devotees. And he also gives mercy to the demons. Because all the demons who are killed by Krishna, they all get liberated. So Krishna is kind to everyone. But he has a special affection for his devotees. And the qualification of devotee is that they have bhakti, they have devotion. That devotion requires that the devotee is just has faith, is completely surrendered to Krishna.
就是要做好这个奉爱的这个最原则，就是要对 Krishna 完全的归依.
He doesn't worship other gods for any maintenance.
要完全的服从 Krishna, 不要去依赖其他的半神人.
We may be thinking, "Oh, I have to get money, I should worship Lakshmi."
不可以这样想啊，我想要钱啊，那我去崇拜Lakshmi女神。
Oh, I have to get health, I have to worship Surya, the sun god.
我要健康，我要去崇拜太阳神。
Oh, I have an exam, I have to worship Saraswati, help me pass my exam.
我要考试，我要去崇拜Saraswati这位女神去。
Oh, I need to put some other gods. I have some big problems. Let me worship Ganesh. He'll destroy the obstacles.
或者是我有好多的问题啊，我要去崇拜这个降头神，去帮我把所有的问题解决。
So many different devas are there for everything.
那有好多的半神人可以帮做不同的事情。
But all of these different devas are all under the control of the one Supreme Lord.
但是这些半神人，他们也是在Krishna的控制下。
Just like in a government, you have many ministers, different departments, and all of them are under the control of the head of the government, maybe one prime minister.
好多的官人还有部门做不同的事情，但是呢，他们全都是在一个首长领导之下。
Just like in Beijing just now, they have the big meeting, and there's 3,000 delegates of the representatives of the Communist Party, and there's one chairman above all of them.
就像刚刚呢，在中国有这个大会，有3000多个的官员全都住在一，聚在一起在北京去开会，但是他们我只有一个领导，
一个主席，
主席，
有3000领导，有一个主席。
Yeah, try to ignore that. Okay, yes.
Okay, so just as there's like that in government, there's one supreme authority. So in the universal government, on this higher level, there's one supreme lord over everyone.
就算一个政府有一个主席，有一个领导，在这个宇宙的政府里面呢，也有一个至尊主。
So Lord Krishna wants to reestablish. He wants to establish himself in Vrindavan also.
所以，Krishna 他也想在 Vrindavan 开始，他是重新定位他的位置。
He doesn't want to see the people wasting their time worshipping other gods.
他不想看到其他的人浪费时间去崇拜其他的半神人。
So he's arranging for his Govardhan Puja.
他开始安排做这个 Govardhan 山的崇拜活动。
Any question?
有没有其他的问题？
Comments? Probably. Yes, Matthew.
I'm just wondering, Krishna, when he explains about himself, he said that out of demigods, I'm Indra, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so why Indra? Because Indra makes so many, let's say, things which are, you know, why he
represents in Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter Krishna is describing his opulences, I think. So among Krishna said among the demigods I am Indra.
马特基的问题就是说，为什么可以 Indra 他会有这个现在的位置？为什么他可以是这样？Maharaj 说回答，说在国家法的第十篇里面，Krishna 是没有付他不同的财富的时候，也有说过，在半神人之中，我就是 Indra。
So Lord Krishna was describing to Arjuna how to see him in all the different aspects of the world.
Krishna 跟 Arjuna 去解释说，在世界不同的方面，可以去怎么去看到他。
So Mataji was saying, why Indra when Indra did so many mistakes?
但 Mataji 的问题其实就是说，为什么 Indra 他可以是天地皇，天地的皇，如果他做了这么多的错
？Yeah, he does some mistakes, but he's the king of heaven.
他做了不好的事情，但是他也是天堂的国王。
So he's taking a great responsibility.
他有很重要的职务。
The demigods, we have to respect the demigods.
而我们要尊敬这些半神人。
But we don't worship them as the supreme god.
但是呢，我们不会把他们当至尊主来崇拜。
But they are empowered representatives of Krishna.
但是呢，他们的力量就是 Krishna 给他们的。
They get that position as demigods or Indra, to be Indra, they have to have performed many pious activities.
如果要这样子的半神人一样，他们可以有他们的力量、工作责任，就是要做好多的崇拜的活动。修行。
Indra, like Brahma, is a position.
就像梵天一样，他是个位置。
So the person who takes that position.They've taken it because of many pious activities.
他们可以成为梵天了，坐在这个重要的位置，是因为他们之前做了好多的灵修啊，严格的修行。
And they're representing, you know, they're helping to keep the universe in order.
他们是一个代表，他们是维持着这个宇宙的运作。
Just like Indra, his job is controlling the rain, distributing the rain.
就像 Indra 他的工作就是要有这个下雨。
So they're doing an important service on behalf of Lord Krishna.
所以呢，这些半神人他们是为 Krishna 做重要的工作。
And of course, there's always challenges from the demons.
当然呢，也有这些恶魔的挑战。
The demons are against the authority of the Lord.
这些恶魔呢，他们是不服从于这些神的，他们的供。
But the demigods, they are obedient to the order of the Lord.
但是半神人呢，他们是服从于神。
And that's why Lord Vishnu often comes and helps the demigods.
所以呢，主Vishnu他是常常要帮助这些半神人。
Because these demigods are his representatives.
Thank you, Maharaj. But if Krishna is going to lecture the Govardhan villages here for worshipping demigods, why didn't he lecture the gopis for worshipping the devas in the rivers when they're taking bath, hoping to get to find a husband?
When the gopis were worshipping,
when the young gopis were taking bath in the river, they were worshipping another god.
Kalyani puja.
Yes, and then he didn't actually chastise them. And
Kalyani puja, that's the gopis are worshipping Kalyani to get Krishna for a husband.
我问的问题是为什么 Krishna 他没有认识这些牧牛姑娘，他们在河里面崇拜其他的半神人。Maharaj Krishna说，因为他这个崇拜的活动，他们是希望得到 Krishna 做他们的丈夫。So
you can worship the demigods, like worship of Kalyani to get Krishna as a husband. That's a lot.
这是说，如果你们就像这个牧羊姑娘一样去做这个崇拜，去希望得到 Krishna 做你的丈夫，这是可以的。And
Krishna satisfies their desire.
而 Krishna 满足他们的愿望。Krishna
became their husband.
Krishna 成为了他们的丈夫。
What happened? Lord Brahma stole away all the cowherd boys.
当梵天偷走了所有的牛和牧牛。
And at that time, Krishna took the place of all the cowherd boys.
那个时候, Krishna 他是代替了这些牧童.
And that happened for 1 year.
那只是发生了一年.
So during that year, that was when all the gopis got married.
这是在哪一年呢? 所有的牧童姑娘他们全都结婚.
They all got married to Krishna.
他们全都嫁给了 Krishna.
But they all thought it's a cowherd boy.
但是他们可能会想，他们是嫁给这个牧童。但其实他是 Krishna， 他们是 Krishna。
So Krishna makes these arrangements for the pleasure of his devotees.
所以呢 ，Krishna 做了这些安排，去满足他们的奉献，他的奉献者。Maharaj
in Mayapur Pradhan, there are some Shiva temples, the protectors of the holy Dham, as we know, and devotees worship. As a devotee of Krishna, as a protector of the Dham.
Mm-hmm.
And that's allowed.
Yeah.
Prabhupada,
Yeah, there's also the deity which is put there in the Jagannath Mandir.
Yeah.
What's the name again? What's that?
Durga.
The mark here in the middle, what's it called?
Shimanta. The island is Shimanta Dweep.
Shimanta. There's a Shimanta Devi. It's a form of Durga, or Yoga Maya.
Yoga Maya Durga. 另外一个形象在圣地也有另外一个形象的，在Mayapur，在那什么？在Jagannath Mandir,
Rajpur, right? They have the Jagannath ISKCON Jagannath Mandir, and in the recent times they've added also a deity of Simanta Devi. In the Jagannath Mandir, near to Mayapur, we have added another deity, a deity of a deity, we have added the deity of a lady called, her name is Simanta Devi.
Simanta Devi.
Simanta, the parting in the hair. They put, ladies put the mark there, the red mark there when they're married, you know, married time. They put that, and they part the hair in the middle, and they have the red here.
Yeah.
So that mark, that place is called Simanta. The Simanta. So there's a form of
Durga,
Yoga Maya.
印度的女人她们结婚的时候头发她们会分开在中间她们会涂一些红色的月亮下面结果是另外一个名称就是Shri Mata然后在这个哪个地方呢她们崇拜的女神也是就是Shri Mata这个名字然后她是Durga女神的另外一个化身。So
there was some discussion whether or not to have this deity here in Mayapur. Because we worship Krishna and Lord Chaitanya. But they put the deity of Lord Chaitanya there, and she is worshipping Lord Chaitanya.
Simanta
Devi is bowing before Lord Chaitanya. She took the dust from Lord Chaitanya and put on her hair. So that's appropriate. That's all right. Because it's Chaitanya Lila. So similarly, gopis were worshipping Katyayini. To get Krishna for a husband. They were doing it for the pleasure of Krishna. We have to know how to please Krishna. But when they were worshipping Indra, to get this was not pleasing Krishna. So Krishna corrected them. Don't worship Indra. Worship Govardhan Hill. And the cows. So we can worship demigods if it's in relation to Krishna. Some devotees, they also worship the demigods, understanding that these demigods are a part of Krishna. And Krishna is the supreme. And demigods are just kind servants of him. So Lord Shiva is the protector of the holy Dham. And when we go to the holy Dham, we have to ask Lord Shiva's permission. But please allow us to enter the holy Dham. When you go to Vrindavan, when you go to Mayapur, first of all you should go to see the Lord Shiva and say, please allow me, I want to come and see the holy place.
Mm-hmm.
Just like they have giant Vijay in the spiritual world.
就像, 灵性世界也有 giant Vijay.
So the Holy Dham, Lord Shiva, is taking care.
在圣地啊,就是主 Shiva, 他在关顾这个。
I have to get his permission.
我们要取得他的许可才可以进去。
So we respect these demi, these devotees.
所以我们尊重这些奉献者。
Lord Shiva is a great
devotee.
But he's not God.
但他不是神。
And Indra is also a devotee.
Indra, 他也是奉献者。
But he's not the supreme.
但他不是至尊的。
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam ki.
Jai.
Prabhupada ki.
Jai.